promised. Oath that I can be guessing. If fair Verona,
make you cry, break, to new mutiny, where civil blood makes civil hands on your knee.
From forth the fatal words of these two foes,
a pair of star-crossed lovers take
their life.
Oh! Whose misadventures piteous overthrows, do with their death bury their parents' right.
The fearful passage of their death marks love,
and the continuance of their parents' rage.
Which, not their children's end, nor could remove, is now the 2 hours' traffic of the vast stage.
Ah, the witch, with patience, ears attend. What here shall miss, our toil shall strive to end.
Tell me, Sam,
Sam's cousin, I do love a woman.
I ain't so near when I supposed you love.
A right good mark, and she's fair, I love.
A right fair mark there has a soon sit.
Well, in that hit, you miss. She'll not be hit by Cupid's arrow if she has dire's wit, and a strong proof of chastity well armed, under love's weak charged bow she lives unharmed.
And she hath sworn that she's soon in chase.
She hath.
People, I forget to think of her.
And teach me how I should forget to think.
By giving liberty unto thine eyes, examine other beauties.
My lord, what say you, my son?
Say the word that I have said before. My child is yet a stranger in the world. She hath merely seen the change in 14 years. Let two more summers with her net pride. Ere we may think her ripe to be a bride.
But younger than she a happy mother's maid.
And too soon married are those who are unmade. Tonight I hold an accustomed feast. Among fresh female buds shall you this night inherit of my house. Here will all see, and like her merit most shall be. Which all will view, that many my being one shall stand in number, though a recreant knight.
Whilst things do dream true.
Ah, so I see Queen Mary. and an agate stone on the forefinger of an ointment, drawn by team of a little asinine over men's noses as they lie asleep. And in this state, she gallops night by night through lovers' brains, and they dream of love. Over lawyers' fingers, and they dream straight of fees. Over ladies' lips, and they straight on kisses dream. Which oft the angry man with blisters play, because their breath with sweetmeats tainted are. Sometimes she driveth over a soldier's neck, and dreams he of cutting foreign throats. And thus, being frightened, swears a prayer or two, and sleeps again. This is the very man that plats the manes of horses by night, and bakes elf locks in foul, sluttish hairs, which once untangled much misfortune bodes. This is the hag, though a maiden's lie presses them and learns them first to bear, making them women of good carriage. This is she.
Peace, peace, Mercutio. Peace. Thou talkest of nothing.
True. I talk of dreams which are children of an idle brain. They go to nothing but vain fantasy. And a spin in substance as is the air, more inconstant than the wind who woos, even now the frozen bosom of the north, thus being angered, puffs away from hence, and turns aside to the dew-dropping sap. This winter talk of blows us from ourselves. Supper is done, we shall come too late.
I fear too early, but my mind misgives. Some consequence, yet hanging by the stars, shall bitterly begin my fearful date. With the night rebel and expire the term of an enclosed life in my breast, by some vile form of untimely death. But he that hath steerage over my course, direct my sail.
Ethiope's ear, for beauty, too rich for use, the earth is dear. So shows a snowy dove trooping with crows, as yonder lady, oh, her fellow shows. The measure done, I'll watch her place of stand, and touching hers, make blessed my rude hand. Did my heart love till now, forswear its sight? There seems such beauty till this night.
this. By his voice, should be a monster. Fetch me my rapier. Who dares to say come here? Come with an antique face to flare a scolatar solemnity. By the stock and honor of my king, I strike you dead. Hold it not a sin.
How now, Kingsman, where more storm you serve?
But uncle, this is a Montague. A foe, a villain come here with such a spite. Scorn at our solemnity this night.
Young Romeo, is it?
It fits. Such a villain is a guest. Tis he, that villain Romeo.
Content thee, gentle cuss. I would not for the world of all the town. Even the disparagement given to my house. Therefore, be patient. Take no notice.
I must enjoy.
He shall be enjoyed.
What good man, boy?
I say he shall. Now go to.
But it is a shame.
Go to. Go to.
Patience perforce, with willful chogomity, makes my flesh tremble with their different reason. I will withdraw, but this intrusion shall, now seeming sweet, convert to bitter gall.
Stand to smooth that rough touch with a tender kiss.
Good pilgrim, you too hold your hand too much, which magic devotion shows me. The saints and hands that pilgrims can be touched, and the arms above is holy palms.
Have not saints lips and holy palms too?
Aye, pilgrim, lips that they must use in prayer.
Oh then, fair lady, let lips do what hands do. They pray. Grant thou fair less despair.
Things do not move, though grant the prayer sake.
And do not move while my great effect I take. Thus from my lips, my sin is purged.
Then have my lips the sin that they have turned.
Sin from my lips, O sweetly urged, trespass again.
He kissed by the moon. Medic, your mother prays to work
for you. What is her mother?
Her mother is the lady of the house.
She a captain?
Away be God. Small says is best.
Aye, sir.
Come hither, nurse. What is your gentleman?
His name is Romeo, and a Montague, the only son of your great enemy.
My only love, sprung from my only hate. Too early see your love, and no too late.
Baptized, it will never be Romeo.
What man
My lady, I know not how to tell you who I am. My name, fair lady, is hateful to myself, it is an enemy to thee. Had I written it, I would tear the word.
My ears have not yet drunk 100 words of that tongue's utterance. But I know the sound. How come of Romeo and of Montague?
Neither, fair saint, neither of these is like.
How camest thou hither? Tell me wherefore. The orchard walls are high and far to climb. In the place death, considering who thou art, if any of my little men find you here.
With love's like wings, I have perched these walls, for so many limits do not hold love out.
Thou knowest the mask of mine is on my face. Else would a maiden's blush to paint my cheeks, but that which thou hast heard me speak tonight. Pain would I tell on the floor. Fain, fain tonight that I have spoken. But farewell, confident. Dost thou love me? I know thou wilt say aye, and I will take thy word. Yet if thou swear, thou mayest be false, and love is perjury. Then say it to me, O gentle Romeo, if thou dost love, pronounce it faithfully.
My lady, by yonder blessed moon, I swear, that tips all these silver fruit tree tops.
Swear not by the moon, the inconstant moon, that monthly changes in her circle fall, lest if thy love prove likewise variable.
Shall I swear by?
Do not swear at all. Or if thou wilt, swear by thy gracious self, which is the god of my idolatry, and I'll believe thee.
My heart's dear love.
Do not swear. Although I joy in thee, I have no joy in this contract tonight. It is too rash, too unadvised, too sudden, too like the lightning which God sees to be, and I can say it lightens. Sleep good night.
Oh, will thou leave me so unsatisfied?
What satisfaction canst thou have tonight?
In exchange of love's faithful vow from mine.
I gave thee mine before thou did profess it, and yet I would it glad to give again.
Madam!
May you see good will. Dear love, adieu. And all good nurse. Sweet Montague, be true. Stay but a little, I will come again.
Three words, dear Romeo.
And good night indeed. If thus by bent of love be honourable, my purpose in marriage, send me word tomorrow, by one that I'll procure to come to thee, where and what time thou wilt perform the rite, and all my fortunes that thy foot are led, will follow thee, my lord, without the world.
Madam!
I can't, madame! But if thou meet not well, I do beseech thee.
Madam!
By and by I come, to seize thy suit and lead thee to my grief. Tomorrow,
so far my soul.
1,000 times tonight.
1,000 times to want thy light. Like schoolboys with heavy looks, as love from love to school with their heavy looks.
Romeo, at 1 o'clock tomorrow shall I sing to thee?
At the hour of 9.
It will not fail. 20 years till then. Good night, good night. Parting is such sweet sorrow. I shall say good night to let you know.
Good morrow, father.
Benedicto, what early tongue so sweet salute?
Ah, young son, it argues a distended head, so soon to every one. Sir bed, or
it is not so than I, said wife, that thou hast not been in bed tonight.
At last is true, sweeter rest was mine.
God pardon sin. Was that what was like?
Was I my ghostly father? No! I've forgotten that name, and that name's woe.
That's my good son. But where hast thou been then?
I've been feasting with my enemy. Where, on a sudden, one hath wounded me. And that's why we wounded. And both our remedies with help and holy physic lies. I bear no hatred, blessed man, for lo. My indecision likewise stays thy foe.
Be plain, good son. I'm holy in my good. With willing confession, fine, but
willing true. Then plainly know my heart is set on the fair daughter of rich Capulet. We met, we wooed, we made exchange of vow. Now tell me as we pass, but this I pray. Thou consent to marry us today.
Holy Saint Francis, what changes here?
It is wonderlike that thou didst so love so near so truthful thing. Young men love thy love truly in their heart, but in their eyes.
I pray thee, chide not. For she who I love now doth grace for grace and love for love allow the other. Did not so.
Ah, she knew well. Thy love did read by oath, but could not spell. But come, young.
go with me. And one less bet of our assistant king. For this alliance may so happy prove this eternal household banker to pure love.
Oh, let his heads stand with sudden haste!
Wisely and slow, they stumble at one bar.
Same pale, hard-hearted wench that was lying torments him so, he's sure to run mad. Tybalt, the king of the old capitalists, has sent a letter to his father's house.
A challenge of my life,
with Romeo will answer it. Any man who can write may answer a letter. Nay, he can answer the letter's master. How he dares be in dark.
Alas, poor Romeo, he's already dead, stabbed with the white wench's black eye, run through the ear with a love song. The very pain of his heart cleft. The blind bowboy's butt sharp. And he is a man to encounter Tybalt.
Why?
More than prince of cats, he is the king of courageous compliments. He fights while you sing prick time, distance, and proportion. He rests his minute, rests one, two, and the third on your bosom. He is the very butcher of the silk button, the gentleman of the very first household of the first and second cause. The immortal Sardo, the Punta Reversa, the hay.
Here comes Romeo.
Ah, you gave us the counterfeit fairly last night.
Who marred you both? Counterfeit, did I give?
The slip, sir, the slip. Do you not conceive?
Pardon, good Mercutio. My business was great. And in such a case as mine, one may strain to curtsy.
Nay, such a case as yours constrains a man to bow in the hand.
Meaning to curse up.
Thou hast most kindly hit it.
The most. It's a serious decision.
Nay, I'm the very pink.
Pink the flower?
Right.
Why then? Is my pomp of flowers?
Sure wit. Follow me, mistress, till thou hast worn out the one. When the singular soul is worn out, the jest may remain and wear the soul singular.
Oh, single soul jest, soul singular for the singular.
Come between us, good Benvolio, before my wits faint. Now, how is this no better than groaning for love? Now art thou sociable? Now art thou Romeo? Now thou art who thou art. By art as well as by nature, for this love is a dribbling natural that runs the lane up and down to hide its pupil in a hole.
Stop there.
Thou desirest me to stop my tail against the hair.
How would his ends have made that so large?
Oh, thou art deceived, for I would have made it short. For I have come to the death of my tail and wish to occupy the argument no more.
Here's the beginning.
A sail.
But he can grow, gentlemen. Gentlemen, can any of you tell me where I can get Romeo?
I can tell you, but young Romeo may be older when you found him and when you sought him. For I am the youngest of an age, a fault or worse.
You say well.
Yes, it's the worst well.
Very well too. Ill fed.
Wisely.
If you be he, sir, I desire some confidence with you.
She even likes to see something.
I will follow you.
Farewell, ancient lady. Farewell.
What a saucy merchant was this that was so full of his roguery?
Gentleman, nurse, he loves to hear himself speak, and will talk more in a minute than he will stand in a month.
Now, before God, I am so vexed that every part of our me could this. I pray you, sir, the words, and as I taught you, my young lady bid me to inquire your heart. What she bid me say, I will keep to myself. But first, let me tell you, if ye should lead her to fool's paradise, as they say, but were a very gross kind of behaviour, as they say, for the gentleman that's young, and therefore, if you should dedouble me for, truly it would be an ill thing to be offered to any gentleman, and verily be deeming.
I protest unto thee.
Good heart, and I say I will tell her as much. Lord, she would be a joyful woman.
What will thou tell her? Dost thou not mark me?
I will tell her, sir, that you protest that this item is a very gentleman I offer.
Tell her, let's go to Friar Lawrence's cell. There shall she be shrived and married. Here's for thy pains.
This afternoon, sir, she shall be there.
The clock struck 9 when I did send the nurse. In half an hour, perchance she cannot meet him.
Oh, that's not so.
Oh, she is lame. Not held dreamy thoughts, which 10 times fast glide in the sun's beam, driving back shadows over lowering hills, and therefore do nimble pinions doubt your love, and therefore hath the wind swift Cupid wing. Now is the sun upon the highmost hill of this day's journey, and from 9 till 12 is 3 long hours, then she has not come. Had she affections and warm youthful love, she'd be swift in motion of all. My words would fancy her to my speaker and his to me. But old folks, many famous men were dead, unwieldy, slow, heavy, and pale as lead. Oh God, she comes! Oh, hi, nurse, what news? A sad old thing. Now, good, sweet nurse. Oh, Lord, why lookest thou so sad?
She see! What haste? Can you not stay away? Do you not see that I'm out of breath?
How art thou out of breath? Then thou hast breath to say to me that thou art out of breath. What say to you of our marriage? What's the plan?
Follow me close.
gentlemen. A word with one of you.
And but one word with one of us. Why not stop it with something? Make it a word and a blow.
Mercutio, thou consorts with Romeo.
Consort? Dost thou make us minstrels? Dost thou make minstrels of us? Look to eat nothing but discourse. Here is my fiddlestick. Here's what shall make you dance. Zans consort. We talk here in the public court of men, either with quantities in private place, and use a copy of the grievances, or as the past, here all lies gaze on us. Men's eyes were made to look, so let them gaze. I will budge for no man's pleasure eye.
Well, please be with you, sir. Here comes my man.
But I'll be hanged, sir, if he wear your livery. Marry, go before to fear. He'll be your follower. His worship in that sense may call you man.
Romeo, the hate I bear cannot afford a better term than this. Thou art a villain!
Tybalt, the reason I have to love thee doth much excuse the appertaining rage in such a greeting. Villain, I am none. Therefore, farewell. Romeo. See thou knowest not.
Romeo, the injuries that you have caused me shall not be excused. Therefore, turn and draw.
I do protest, I never injured thee. But love thee better than thou must suffice, till thou shalt know the reason of my love. And so, good Capulet, whose name I tender as much as my own, be satisfied.
Oh, calm this horrible vile submission. Tybalt, you rat catcher, will you walk?
I am here.
Draw then, Mario! See down the weapon! Hold Tio! Mercutio!
Be blind. It best agrees with none.
in this neighbourhood. Hood my unmanned love, bathing my cheeks with thy black mantle till strange love grow bold. Big true love at simple modesty. Come night, come Romeo, come now day and night, for thou wilt lie upon the wings of night, whiter than new snow upon the broken back. Come soon night, come loving black browed night. Give me my Romeo, and when he shall die, take him and cut him out into little stuff, and he will make the face of heaven so fine that all the world will be in love with night and pay no worship to the garish sun. Oh, here comes my aunt, and she brings me, and every tongue that speaks but Romeo's name sees heaven and heaven. I mean, what are you? Why test thou with my hand?
Well, he's dead. He's gone, his king is dead. Romeo, who ever would have thought that?
Romeo's slain himself.
I saw the wounds. I saw them with my eyes. Oh, break my heart, poor bankrupt, break at once. To prison eyes never look on liberty. Vile earth to earth resign, end motion here. And thou and Romeo press my head in here.
To be the best friend I had. Oh, courteous to look, honest gentleman. If I should live to see thee dead.
What storm is this that blows so contrary? Is Romeo slaughtered?
Romeo's gone, to banish! Romeo, let Caesar be banished!
If Romeo's hand shed too much blood?
It did, less than day it is!
Oh, servant heart, here with a flowering face, did ever dragon keep so fair a case?
There's no faith, no trust, no honesty in men, or pursued, or forsworn, or lord, or descended. Shame, come, to Romeo!
Please give me thy tongue for such a wish!
We should tell us that he's your cousin!
Tell me, what vile part of this is that?
dog by name Lodge. Tell me that I'm accept that he will not you!
Hold thy desperate hand by your damn ears upon myself. Go. Get thee to lie down. Across the tree. Ascend her chamber, hence. But say not to Lord to be sent. For then thou canst not pass Mantua. Without thou shalt live, we can find a time to braid your marriage and beckon your friends. Beg pardon of the prince. And call thee back with 20,000 times more joy than I went first forth to the lamentation.
Go before us, commend me to thy lady, that I hasten all the house to bed, which makes every soil make him act unto Romeo is coming.
My lord,
I
tell my lady she will come.
Make a desperate tender of my child's love. I believe she will be ruled in all respects by me. Nay more, I doubt it not. Why? Go to Juliet and go to bed. And pray to hear of my son, Paris in love. And bid her, mark you me, on the way to yes. Stop. What day is this?
Monday.
Monday, how well? Wednesday is too soon, but what say you to Thursday?
My lord, I will let Thursday by tomorrow.
Oh, well, Thursday here, get you job. Go to Julius, you go to bed. Prepare for this fine wedding day. Farewell, my lord. And that we have a curse in heaven.
out on her hiding!
God in heaven bless her. You have to blame, my lord, to raise her side.
Peace, you mumbling fool! Utter your gravity over gossip bowl, for here we need it not.
My father, are you mad? Good father, I beseech you on my knees!
Hurry, young rabbit! Disobedient wretch! God's bread, it makes me mad! Day, night, hour, time, tide, work, play! A lonely lover, still my care has been to have her matched. And now, having provided a gentleman of noble parentage, stacked, as they say, with honourable parts, proportioned as one could wish a man, and then to have some wretched, puling fool, a whining mermaid in her fortune's tender, to answer,
I cannot love, I am too young. I pray you pardon me.
But as you will not wed, I will love you. Praise where you will, but you shall not out with me! Look toward and bethink you, I do not use suggestion.
Thursday is near. Lay hand on heart with advice and you will be mine. I will give it to my friend. Did you not hang? Beg,
starve, die in the streets, for by my soul, I will never acknowledge thee. Look towards and bethink you, I will not be your sword.
Sweet my mother, cast me not away, delay this marriage for a month, a week. Thou not, paint the bridal bed in that dear monument where Tybalt lies. Talk to me not, for I will not talk a word, do as thou wilt. As I have done thee. Oh, God, how shall this be prevented? Faith, here it is. I think it best be married for the county. I think you are heavy in the second bench. For it excites your first, or if it did not, your first steps to where scarce you were, be living here for the use of him. Well, thou hast come to be marvellous much. Go in and tell my lady I have gone.
Please, my father, to Lawrence himself to make confession and to be of his call. Marry out, and this is why I see time. Thursday, sir. The time is very short. My father Capulet will have it so, and I am nothing stoked to stack his head.
And would I knew not why it should flow.
My lord, take on the lady for myself.
Happily then, my lady and my wife.
That may be so, and I may be a wife.
That may be, must be. Love on Thursday next.
What must be, shall be.
That's a certain text. Coming to make confession to his father.
I shall home, Father, now. Shall I come to the evening mass?
My leisure serves me, pensive daughter. My lord, you must entreat the time of
God, shield, sister. Juliet, on Thursday early I will rouse you. Till then, and keep this holy kiss.
Oh, shut the door! Oh, when thou hast done so, come weep with me, past home, past skill, past help!
Ah, Juliet, only know thy grief, it strains me beyond the compass of my wits. But hear me, master. And nothing may prove it. On Thursday next, be married to me.
Tell me not, Friar, that thou hast heard of this, unless thou may tell me how I may prevent it. If in thy wisdom thou canst give no help, do but call my resolution wise, and give this night my
hope. Hold, daughter! I do spy a kind of hope, which craves a desperate execution.
Oh, bid me leave, father, than marry Paris.
Hold. Then, go home. Be happy. Give consent to marry Paris. Wednesday is tomorrow. Tomorrow night? Look, that thou lie alone. And let not thy nurse lie with thee in thy chamber. And take thou this vial. Being then in bed, this distilled liquor drink thou on, when presently, through all thy veins shall run, a cold and jealous humour, but for a cause, shall
shall keep his native progress, heart says he's. No warmth, no breath, shall testify thy lips, and the rose in thy lips and cheeks shall be pains to pay the ashes, thy eyes windows fall like death when he shuts up the day of life. Each part deprived of supple government shall, stiff and stark and cold, appear like death. And in this boy, my little shrunken, thou shalt continue 2 and 40 hours, and then awake as from a pleasant sleep. When thy bridegroom in the morning comes, rouse thee from thy bed, there art thou dead. And in the manner of our country is, in thy best robes uncovered and beard, thou shalt be born to same ancient vaults where all the kindred of the Capulets lie. In the meantime, again, it's time to talk. Shall Romeo buy my lessons? No, I didn't. And hither shall he come. And he and I will watch thy way. And that very night he will bear thee his mantle, where thou shalt be free of thy present shame. If no womanish fear, nor inconsistent coy, I bait thy valour in the act.
Dreamt my lady came and found me dead. A strange dream that gives a dead man leave to think. I breathed such kisses with my lips and revived and was an emperor. Lucius Verona, how now, Balthasar? Dost thou bring me letters from the friar? How is my lady? Is she well? For nothing can be ill if she is okay.
Then she is well, and nothing can be ill.
that so? Then I defy you, stars! I will lie with thee tonight.
I do beseech you, sir, have patience. Your looks are pale and wild. Do report of this adventure.
Come up, bring me letters from the friar.
No, good lord.
Well then, Juliet, I'm sliding with thee tonight. Apothecary! Come here, man, I see that thou art poor. Hold, there's 40 ducats. Let me have a dram of poison such soon speed and gear as we disperse itself throughout all thy veins. And let the life weary may fall dead, and let the trunk may be discharged the breath as hastily as power fired from the fatal cannon's wound.
Such mortal drugs I do possess, but Mantua's law is death to any he that touches them.
Art thou so wretchedness and fearest to die? And take thee, and be not poor.
My poverty, but not my will, consents.
Pay thy poverty, not thy will.
Take this, and put it in any wicked thing that you will. And if you have the strength of 20 men, we will dispatch you straight.
There is thy worst gold, doing more damage to men's hearts in this wretched world. Come with me, compounds, not poison. Come to Juliet's cell. There I shall use thee.
Holy Francis of Friar, come home!
Ah, welcome to Mantua. What says Romeo? Or, if his mind knew it, give me his letter.
Could not send it. Here it is again.
Oh, unhappy fortune. By my brotherhood, this letter was not nice, but full of charge of dear import, and neglecting it could lead to much danger. I must write again to Mantua. Keep Juliet at my cell till Romeo come. Calling his corpse, clothed in dead man's tomb. This is that banished, haughty Montague, that murdered my love's cousin, with which grief it is supposed the fair creature died. And here he's come to do some villainous shame to the dead bodies. Stop thine hallowed toil, vile Montague. Can vengeance be pursued further than death? Condemned villain, I do apprehend thee. Obey and go with me, for thou must die. I must indeed. Therefore came I hither. Yet, why are they so pale?
heights of your loss. In thy lips, holdest the doors of bread, sealed with the righteous. Kiss you, my love.
Morning with it brings. The sun, for sorrow, will not show his head.
Go hence, talk more of these sad things. Some shall be pardoned, some punished. For never was a story of more woe than this of Juliet and her Romeo.